Somehow I hear the soundtrack of a toilet flushing in the background. Oh my goodness, what could go wrong today? We have a kit guitar, which is really just awful. And, you know, I mean, I'll do it for the guy, but it's like no wonder he just gave up. Because when you look through the instructions as to how to put this turkey together, and we get to the final wiring diagram, right? We're going to do this. And he hands me the parts. Well, I'm sorry, boss, but this thing's got only one tone and two volumes. And this diagram shows two tones and one volume. So if you were confused in the beginning, you'd be more confused by the time you got to the end. This is just hilarious. The instructions, things you'll need, tools you need. There, I can zoom in a little bit. All right. You'll need sandpaper, a blowtorch, some pyrotechnics, a flamethrower, and a good fire pit. That's what I'm thinking. A power drill, screwdrivers. They don't tell you which ones, just any screwdriver will fucking do, right? Masking tape, a soldering iron and solder. I think they gave you like a in here. That's why I'm wondering, like, am I the first guy here that, no, this is what they gave. There's only one tone, two volumes, right? I don't even want to read this. Okay, so apparently somebody, anyhow, buddy brought it to me. The first thing that was not right was you need that ground wire, right, guys? I'll get a little better work on this here. Yeah, you need that ground wire. So someone decided they were going to install the stud bushings and didn't know that you needed to have that touch that. So getting that out of there, just a quick lesson. I don't know what I did with the machine screw, but the bushing's hollow, right? It's through. You can see the wood below. So what you do is you drop a machine screw of the right height into that hole. Then you use this stud to push that thing you drop down that hole against the wood in the back, and that pushes the bushing out. That's how it works. Except on this guitar, the wood is so soft that the first screw I dropped in there managed to push itself right into the body of the guitar, and I was as scared it was going to pop through. And this isn't even wood. This is like hot dog wood, right? What kind of meat is in a hot dog? Same question as to what kind of wood is in this guitar body. Then the next funny part of this is this guy bought these unbelievably expensive Fishman pickups, which I haven't looked at inside at all. The pickups are probably worth twice the cost of the kit. That's almost $400 worth of magnetism there. Right, isn't that nuts? Right? But hey, what could go wrong? Come on, stand by. Well, like I said, I wish I had gotten that on camera, but I figured, oh no, I'm just going to put the ground wire in now because the last guy forgot. Okay, that's done. Now we have this, and let's get the pickups out because the pickups have to get mounted into that. Then we have to drag the leads through the body, and I'll mount the controls on here, and then we can make some solder connections. But I don't know about this harness. I'm a little skeptical. We'll see what happens. And then we gotta put that guy on there, and it requires a setup. I'm just looking at the string nut down here at the other end, and there is no way that is ever going to work. It's all the slots are going to have to be recut. And whoever painted the guitar painted over top of the nut. Nice work. Wow, look at this schwaz. Now that I open it up, you get all new parts. Isn't that nice? Except this shitty switch, I don't think can be reused, and nor do I want to use it. None of this is of any use. I didn't realize this was just some big old active hot. More than needed stuff. Anyway, why don't we I don't want to reuse that. We're going to get a different switch. My next laugh of the day is that these pickups don't fit through the frickin' holes. So I just let Buddy know there's a lot of stuff here to sort out, you know. So all I'm going to say is don't buy a kick guitar. Just go buy a fucking guitar. Really? Like, really?
Well,
it was supposed to be a couple hours of soldering. I think we've almost burned up half of that now. It's not a lot, but just enough to add another ass pain to my day. What do we think? Nope, not even freaking close. Gonna be like a 32nd of an inch. Off both sides, right? Because if you take it off just one side, notice how I'm using the rat tail to reestablish the radius. You notice how I'm making a big freaking mess again? Oh, we're getting closer, folks. We're getting closer. A little bit more. Don't you love that sound? I love the sound of that. That just makes my fucking day. Yeah, and I know I'm using the file back and forth. Give me shit. What are you gonna do? Oh, come on, honey. You can do it. Oh, look at that. It went in. Let's do the next one. So, sort of back to what I was figuring was going to happen. This is a lot of wire that has to go through everything. So this worked out, but this pass through is nowhere near big enough. So I need to, I can get one set through, but the other set, I am really doubting that will pull through. I'm going to try. Yeah, I'm not going to try. It's not going to work. I got to open that up. Okay. Have fun yet? Oh, I know I am. I can't wait to put strings on this and see how turkey-like it's going to gobble. You watch. You know, so it's like I'm just at the point where I just want to drink. I'm sorry. So, this guy, we got to cut all the screws that adjust the pickups all have to be chopped off, which isn't a big deal, but I'm glad I checked that before I got all horny about putting it back together. The other problem is to do this is I really need, right, you see I'm struggling here to get it as tight to the guitar as I can, but I need the wire to make the connections because they all have to go here. And then what's that? What that's going to do is when I have to pull this back into the guitar, it's going to end up a big piss pot full of wires in the cavity, and I'm not even sure if a battery's going to fit in there yet, but I'll go as far as I can and just hand it back to the guy. I really don't have a big fan club for kit guitars because you couldn't pay me by the hour to make this work, but I guess you are at this point. Fun times. So now I gotta improvise because there's only one tone control, It doesn't matter. It's just, it'll all work out. But what will end up happening is I'm just going to make the tone control first. And the deal is, oh, sorry for the fucked up camera. But they show the capacitor, those two lugs on the push-pull get shorted together. That gets grounded on the pot. Then we've got another ground point on the pot. And then that goes to the lug on the actual control. Well, what you can do, let's see if I can get you in the movie here best I can. Just use the lead of the capacitor to do that little jumper. And then I'm going to tag that lead onto the side of the push pull. And then I'm going to put a little bit of heat shrink around that lead that just shouldn't touch anything, and then solder it there. Right? It's like if you get into doing what they would expect you to do, guys, you're going to end up, this is how you see all these solder jobs with a big blob, a big huge mess, because you didn't think through that there's 1, 2, 3 points that need to be grounded. And if you pulled those all together, that's one solder connection, not 3 solder connections, right? Same here on the back of that pot. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 solder connections, and that should just be one spot. Get all those wires ready. You get it? And even on the tone, I still need a jumper to the volume, so that's an extra one that I have to tag on the outside of that, which I might do before I even, you know, you get what I'm saying. Pull them together, do it once. Okay, so tiny bit of flux on all terminals. Can't tin that wire. The other thing to always remember is put a clippy clip on the other side of the capacitor as a heat sink, so you fire capacitor. And I'm just going to do this, and then I got to run the fan, guys, because I'm tired of huffing this shit. I'm just going to tin the tip a little bit. Get your face out of the schwaz. Put a little heat on there. That's that. I'll be able to twist that around where I need it to go after. That's that. Two done, 50 more to go. So back to trying to keep it neat. I've got 1, 2, 3 points. So I have made that wire, and if we look closely, that's my tone control. So now I'll put a little heat shrink on that open lead, and that's pretty much it. The only thing that will be left is one other connection to the center of the tone control that comes from the volume control for the bridge pick. All right, like I said, I gotta run the fan. I'm just gonna go through, but I just wanted to show you some, like I said, those are tricks. That's how you not make a mess, right? Figure out how many wires need to be connected together. Back to that, connecting the tone control, I'm going to use one, so I've got 4 little wires that have to connect to that. Even 2 wires, even 2 of these guys over here on that little lug, yeah, you know, it's easy to make a mess. So what will happen is I'll pull all 4 of those together, a little heat shrink, it'll turn into a single wire, done. So back to what I was saying, pulling all those wires to a single wire and then hitting that terminal, otherwise you're in deep shit. So that's the tone control. According to the drawing, there's only one connection that needs to be made, and that's at the center lug, and that's a single connection, so I don't have to worry about that. But I do need to work backwards towards the volume control, because you see on that lug there's 2 connections. So we'd like to get all this, you know, those 2 wires there and hit it once instead of, you get it? It's a little thinking. But if you take a time, and like I said, figure out all those things that all connect to one spot, right? And do them once, it's a much a nicer job.
Sorry for the fan noise, but after a while your brain just hurts, and I really don't think all this stuff's going to fit in this hole with the battery. Please, please, please prove me wrong. Otherwise, I just got to give it back to the guy or tell him that somehow we have to cut a battery box into a cardboard guitar. That's a lot of wires. And I'm still not done. Almost, though. Close. 2 more wires, 3 more wires, and some connections.
Well, that's sort of it, guys. I'm out of wires and places to connect them. So I'm going to plug it in, and if it makes a smoke show, I'm just going to bed.
Well, this was super scary because I plugged it in. You can't hear nothing, right? That's how quiet these pickups are, right? Switch ain't working right. Son of a beach guy. Why do I have everything all the time? So, I pulled out the switch. And basically right now, what I have, I figured out why this is never gonna work right. But Buddy's just gonna have to live with it because he's gonna have to live with it. Right now, front pickup, hotwired, right? Everything works as planned. This thing seems to do something, tough to say without strings on it. But I think it does do tone. Yeah, sure, right? You can hear that. But this pickup is not connected to the output right now at all. The wire's hanging here. But it's still connected through the tone because that's the way it's going to work. This is meant to have 2 independent tone controls. And that's life, dude. Sorry. It's the way she blows. What a Rubik's Cube of bullshit. Buddy's going to be disappointed, but, you know, you can always take the expensive pickups out and put the junk in that was meant to be. We're not junk, but this is not, like I said, it has to have, as I look at the circuit now, I realize it has to have independent tone controls or it will not work. So, with that being said, you get what you get. It makes sound. Wrap your 9-volt battery, especially when it's going to flop around in there like a bunny. And I did have this figured out which way it could actually sit in there. A second ago, I think that was it. Something like that. Wish me luck. That's it. Screw it down and run away. Well, make sure it makes sound, or the sound that it'll make, which, yeah, baby. Look at those. So, it's master volume, baby. Yeah, that's all you get. And that works. Well, that sort of sucks. Sorry, guy, but Fishman boned you. You thought something with 4 controls that only has 3. I don't know what to tell you. I took some pictures. I'll explain to him and he can decide what he wants to do. I'm going to quit. I was going to set this thing up for him, but he's blown his budget and he won't be happy anyway. So why even continue? I'm going to button this up and quit. Once again, I apologize for the background noise, but you can't have this, and you can't improvise this. It has to be this. And you see, those are negated. So now we have, and Buddy may or not be happy or not, but this is all you can do with this guitar, because I can't put 4 controls in it. So we're going to have a tone,
and a volume and a selector switch and a pushy pull thing that splits these things in half somehow. That's all I know.
Yeah, seriously, dudes, I gotta go drink. This is just, you know, but like I know these lessons. I shouldn't have tried to improvise. And that's because these have a preamp built inside of them. And I'm sorry, my friend, but that's all you get. You don't have enough holes or space in your guitar. Cheers, folks.